Hi guys, and welcome to this new video. In the last few weeks I had the opportunity to play some acoustic songs, and the problem is always the same, trying to improve the sound of the piezo pickup. I tried combining various equalizers, but without good results. So I looked for a way to create an impulse response myself. Just to be clear, this is only my personal solution, using Reaper as a DAW, and without having to buy plugins like QMatch or similar. The next few minutes will be rather technical, but I hope also interesting, and I hope they can be useful to you. Okay, so to create an impulse response, you need at least two tracks. A reference track with the sound you want, and a target track with the piezo sound. For the moment, let's assume that my reference track is the sound recorded by this condenser microphone here, and I also have connected my piezo pickup. So you need a sound card with at least two inputs. One input for the condenser microphone and the other input for the piezo pickup. Okay, now I have Reaper with an empty project. Here we are. We have to create the two tracks. Mic. Piezo. Now I have my mic in input 1 and the piezo guitar in input 2. So now I will mute my webcam audio and I will record these two tracks at the same time. So let's listen to the sounds. The piezo. And the microphone. Okay, the microphone is better. However, I don't want to use my microphone track as a reference. I prefer to use a lesson by James Taylor, available on YouTube, on his YouTube channel. I suggest you to take a look because there is so much to learn from him. Obviously, James Taylor's sound doesn't come from an impulse response. It comes from his fingers and his bionic nails. Anyway, I have already cut the necessary parts because I only need the intro and the chorus. So I grab them here. It's too loud, so I reduce the volume. And this is the sound from YouTube channel. Now, for comparing the two sounds, we can use a free spectrum analyzer. It's the Voxengo Span. I load my defaults. Give a color of blue, for example. Okay. To have in the same graph also the equalization curve from James Taylor, I have to send the track to the same piezo track and choose new channels, for example 3 and 4. In this way, the Voxengo Span in the routing table will have 4 inputs The first two from the piezo track and 3 and 4 from the Taylor track. I can change the group names to be clear. This is piezo. This is Taylor, for example. So I can say 3 and 4 is for Taylor. Now I switch to Taylor, change the color to green. Plot defaults, and in underlay we select to see piezo. Okay, so now we have two sounds. Can play again. Now, for the basic EQ match, there is a free VST from this site. You have to take this address and add to the extensions repack repositories. So you will have this new repository and you will have the free VST for EQ matching. First, we want to add the VST to the Taylor track. This is the name, Spectrum Matcher. And we have to learn the Taylor curve with the maximum resolution and playing the track. Now we have to save this preset. You can say Taylor couple free. And we do the same thing in the piezo track. So we add the matcher, we load our preset, and we play the track. Now we have the Taylor curve above and the piezo curve here. We can press correct, and this is the correction that we'll make. Okay, now this is the sound with the spectrum matcher. And without. Now I want to improve the sound with the other equalizers. Take the rear EQ. So we have a lot of rumble here in the low frequencies. So I have to cut them to about 30 Hz, it's okay. And then I will search for bad frequencies. So let's play again. That I don't like. So I reduce the gain. Let's search again. And to give some air to the sound, we can boost the frequencies at about 5 kHz. Maybe with the high shelf, okay. Using the band. Yeah, more or less this. Okay, the last VST I want to use is the fresh air. Translate digital, it's free. And it is very powerful because you can increase the mid response and also the high response. Without. So again, this is the sound without effects. I think there is a big difference. So the next step for creating the impulse response is the deconvolution. Reaper has a free deconvolution tool inside Reverb. So this is how to do. We duplicate the piezo track. We remove the sound and call this sweep. Now in the FX change, I can remove the Voxango span. I have all the equalization here, and I add the reverb. Now there is a trick. We have to add a file and press cancel. In this way, two buttons will appear. The first is for generating a test tone. We can select sweep 9 seconds. 24 bits for PCM and save. Now, if we import this sweep, we can reduce the volume here because it's too loud. So be careful to your ears. Now we can listen to this sound. Covers all the frequencies. Now we activate the effects again. We select 10 seconds and we have to render this file. give a name, sweep EQ, 44 kilohertz, mono, time selection. If we render this, we have our sweep with the equalization curve. Now it is time for the deconvolution. So we go back again in the reverb, and this time we select deconvolve. Reaper will ask for the file to be deconvolved, that is our sweep EQ. Then it will ask for the test tone used, that is our sweep. And finally the name for the deconvolved file, sweep deconvolved. We use always 24 bits for the PCM and save. Now the last operations to finish our impulse response, we have to create a new track. This is our IR. We can import the deconvolved file. As you can see, it is very short. We can normalize the item to 0 dB, and also we can cut the file because it's too long. The properties and cut to 2 cents of a second. Okay, now we can select only this part and we can render our final impulse response. This time with the correct name. So my guitar is an XL and I want Taylor Capo 3 mono PCM render. So this is our impulse response. We can test the impulse response on the piezo track. So we can disable all the effects, add the reverb, wet and not dry, add the file, take the impulse response. So here you can see the equalization and test the sound. Now on my Helix patch I put the impulse response as the first block, followed by a preamp, a slight compressor and a reverb.